What is up, fellow believers? Yes, and those that want to get closer, build their relationship closer to YAH. Okay, so we need to talk, right? This is something that affects all of us. And we all fall short. We all make mistakes. Our very nature is sinful because of the world that we were born into. You know what I'm saying? And that's why we need Yahusha. That's why we need the Most High. So this message is for me just as much as anybody else. This is something I have to remind myself of. If I'm getting involved in or entangled in something that is not pleasing to the Most High, then I should expect the consequences. If I'm doing something that is out of the will, and I know it's out of His will, I need to be working to undo that thing, right? So anyway, before we get started, I just want to let y'all know that the scripture is Proverbs chapter 5, verse 22, and I'm reading from the CSB version. And like I said, again, it applies to everybody that is human. Okay, so it says, a wicked man's iniquities entrap him. He is entangled in the ropes of his own sin. So yeah, if y'all want to find out how I got to this verse, how Holy Spirit, Ruach HaKodesh, blessed me with this concept, stick around till the end of the video.
Diamond Destiny's got jewels.
Spirit is so good. Ruach HaKodesh is so amazing. So, you know, we all try to make sense of why things aren't going the way we want them to go. Why is YAH, why is God not doing, or why is He not fixing my problem yet, right? So He showed me something today. We have this cable system that's just hooked to your tree, you know, in the backyard. We have two of them because we have two dogs. And on that cabling system is two of them. It's like a trolley. They can walk back and forth to and from, you know, the backyard. And every time I want to give them something, when I go up to them, they're already tangled up because the cables are next to each other. You can kind of hear it on the background now as they walk back and forth. So they tangle up because they like to wrestle. And when they're side by side, the cables intertwine together and tangle up together every time they want to wrestle. Even though they know that the consequences, man, we're going to be stuck together. We got to walk together. Even when one doesn't want to go in one direction, we both got to go now because we're tied up. So let me tell you, you know, that's the problem that those two are making on their own. They know that I tell them not to wrestle when they're on that, when they hooked up to that line, right? So they know that they're not supposed to, but they do it anyway. And when they do it, they face natural consequences. The natural consequence of getting tangled up together. You know, if he want to go this way, I have to go this way. If she want to go that way, I have to go that way. Or I'm going to be dragged along on the ground. And when I come out to bring them food or a toy or a treat, it's hard for me to give it to them because they're tangled up. And each one might take the other's food, toy, treat, whatever it is, right? And they're gonna start fighting. So God was showing me, Yah was showing me that when we don't follow his instructions, we wonder why we're not getting the blessings. It's hard for him to give us things when we're tangled up in our drama, when we're tangled up in our toxic relationships, when we're tangled up in sin, not listening to him. And it's so funny when you watch life or you just observe the things around you, he's talking to us all the time. Oh, it is so crazy. So if you're in an unequally yoked relationship, right, you either get equally yoked, right? Like y'all both need to start following Yah and have the similar values and have that similar depth of seriousness towards him. You got to pray together. You got to talk about things that you don't want to talk about. And you got to forgive after those fights. You got to forgive every time, no matter who's wrong or who's right. You still got to forgive because you get offended after you argue or fight with somebody. Well, anyway, back to the dogs. So God is showing me that we keep wanting him to bless our mess, bless our entanglements, bless our sin. But he's a just God. Yah is just and holy and wants us to live set apart. He gave us rules and commandments, but we think we don't have to follow them. And then we get upset at him like, why did this happen? Why am I not getting my food on time? Why am I not getting my, you know, the job I wanted, the dream house I wanted? Or why am I not advancing in my gifts and talents? You know what I'm saying? So he's showing me a lot. And it's so crazy because I have two dogs, which represents any relationship or bond with two people, right? It can be a marriage. It can be mother and daughter, friendships, whatever. When you tangle up with the wrong people, they will drag you in their mess. You start to share demons and whatever problems they have, they transfer just like bad germs. And what's crazy is my dogs, if I leave them alone long enough, they figure out how to untangle themselves. They figure out what they did wrong. It might take 30 minutes to an hour, sometimes 5 minutes. But if I leave them alone, like Yah does us sometimes, he lets us be alone, they learn. They untangle themselves and they figure it out. Other times, they are so anxious and full of anxiety that they can't figure it out. And it is so crazy. That's how us humans are. We are just like that situation. It's almost like when they're full of anxiety and worry and they're like, I can't figure it out, they get tangled up even more. But if they were to work together or look above them, they could see that they're tangled up or how they got into it. Me being the pet owner, I can see how it's tangled up from above, from where I'm standing. So I'll just unhook it and untangle it or make them walk around backwards from how they got in there. Just like God, he can see the problem from way up above. He can see the whole situation where you went wrong and he knows the solution to the problem. But sometimes we got to sit still, listen to the instruction to untangle ourselves out of the problem. Let him work on some problems. But we got to sit still enough to let it happen. When they're full of anxious, anxiety, worry, doubt, they, at times when I'm trying to help them, they won't sit still, so I can't even get them out of it. I'm not God, so you know what I'm saying? And I think he does the same thing. If we're doing too much, he's like, okay, I'm going to let you do you then. I can't help you if you're not going to listen to me. And you know, when they are like that, when they are barking, jumping around, and I'm trying to get them untangled, it's almost impossible. They won't sit still. They won't listen to instructions, so I can't help them. And then the same way, the Most High does us just like that. Sometimes we got to sit still, listen to his instruction, wait on his instruction before we do stuff. Sometimes we need to sit still. And the answer to the problem or the solution is right there, But when we're full of worry, anxiety, we do desperate stuff. Sometimes we'll make the problem worse. Sometimes we'll get deeper into our mess, deeper into more entanglements. So yeah, I just wanted to share that with y'all real quick, because Holy Spirit is always showing us things. If we just sit and be observant, there are a lot of times He will show us stuff from His viewpoint, right? And even when the dogs are being disobedient, even when they are in their mess, I still love them and I still want to help them. Same way with Yahuwah, same way with Most High. He still loves us. He still wants to help us. But the reason He doesn't act in certain times and moments is because we are doing something wrong and we got to stop doing it in order for Him to help us, right? So yeah, this applies to a lot of different situations. Unequally yoked marriages and relationships, toxic friends, or just doing what you want to do. Doing what you want to do when it's not in the will of the Most High. So I hope this message blesses you guys. Please leave a comment if this resonated with you, or if you know about a similar situation that I didn't talk about. I want to share your situation and how Yah is working in your life when you sat down, or He's not yet answered your question or your prayer, because you know for a fact it's something that you're doing that you need to stop doing. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.